We have sales rep and sales. And for each team, we need to calculate the average. Well, back in Excel magic trick 1645, that's the formula we used. But that's a big formula. Luckily, our YouTube teammates Bill Sizzes and CRGR912 showed us a better formula. Now, fundamentally, this is an OR logical test. Because for every row for team number one, we have to ask, is the sales rep equal to Sue or Chin or Ty or Chantel or Mento or Carmel? Now, if our report needs the sum, count, and average based on the OR logical test, we can use a couple of formulas that will work in any version of Excel. Now, for sum range, I'm going to come up, and this is an Excel table. So when I see my black arrow, I click. There's the table name and the column name. Those are all the numbers I potentially want to add, comma. Well, I need to look through the sales rep column, comma. And when we're doing an OR logical test, writing criteria 1 that normally expects a single cell, we can give it all of the items. Because we just gave some ifs, 6 different conditions or criteria, when I close parentheses and hit the F9 key, it delivers a conditional sum for each one of the teammates. And that's exactly what we need if we're doing an OR logical test to try and add the sales for this team. Control Z. Now that formula right there, criteria 1, that's called a function argument array operation because we gave it multiple items and it tells SUMIFS to deliver multiple answers. But that means this is an array formula. So if you want to add, you can use the sum function. If you're in Office 365, that's it. You close off the parentheses and enter it. If you're in earlier versions, then you close off the parentheses and use the keystroke Ctrl+Shift+Enter. But there's a better way. Instead of using sum, we can use SUMPRODUCT. By simply putting the array calculation you want to add right into array 1, SUMPRODUCT does not require any special keystroke. Now I'm going to enter this using Ctrl+Enter because I want to put it in the cell and keep the cell selected. But because we're using table names, if I copy the formula pointing to the fill handle with my crosshair or angry rabbit, I get an error. And the reason why is when you use the fill handle to copy a formula with table column names, they're programmed to move as if they were a relative cell reference. Now what happened was we had sum range here. Because there's only 2 columns, it automatically switched from the sales back to the first column. If I copy this to the side, well, that one's right because it switched again. No worries. Control Z, Z. Rather than using our crosshair or angry rabbit, I'm going to use Control C, Shift, Arrow, 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 Control V. So any other copying method besides using the crosshair or angry rabbit will get you the correct results. Now for counting, equals sum product, and we'll just go straight to count ifs. Criteria range, there it is, comma. And then we give it, as a relative cell reference, the team names. Close parentheses, similar to some ifs. Now, this formula construction will do an OR logical test and count. Now, Control Enter. And now I'm going to Shift and hold my arrow key and then use Control R to fill to the right. Now, if your report does require sum and count, we have what we need for average. I'm going to say the total sum divided by the count. Control Enter. And this formula has no problem with the angry rabbit and copying. Now, if you don't have these first 2 cells, then we can easily use the average function. And then inside of the average, we want to use the if function to filter and get only the sales values that we want. I'm going to point to the entire sales rep column. And I would just like to highlight. But we can't directly compare this column because it has fewer items than this column. However, if we use the transpose, now we're doing an array operation with an equal sign on a column and a row. And the result, if I hit the F9, will give us trues and falses. Control Z, that we can now use, comma, to pick out the correct sales values. Now, when I close parentheses on if, I'm not putting value if false, because when you leave that out, it'll put a false in. So when I F9, you could see we have some of the values we need. The falses will be ignored. Control-Z. This formula definitely needs to be entered in earlier versions with Control-Shift and Enter. You could see up in the formula bar those curly brackets. That tells you Excel understood this as an array formula and calculated as such. If you are in Office 365, then you simply Control-Enter, Enter, or however you want. Shift, Arrow, Arrow, Control-R. All right, the last formula equals average. Well, if you're in Office 365, we can use the amazing filter function. Now, I want to filter the sales values, comma, and I would like to include, and here's where we could use the match function. Now, the match function looks up an item and tells you the relative position of an item in a list, and we want to simultaneously look up everybody in this column and find out if they're on a team. Now, we have to use exact match. So for this formula, we're going to have to use match type exact match. Well, if that's the case, we can use the new XMATCH. The difference being is that the default is exact match. So now I'm going to give it the entire column. And the reason we're giving it the entire column with about 50,000 rows is it'll simultaneously look through here and deliver a number 1 to 6. When the sales rep is not in this list over here, it'll deliver an NA, comma. So the lookup array is as relative cell references the team. And the default is exact match, so we simply close parentheses. Now, that's not going to work, but if we F9, we can see there's the pattern, NA or a number. Control-Z, so we can wrap is number around that. And then in the include argument, if I F9, there's my trues and falses. So that filter will deliver the correct set of numbers to the average. Control-Enter. And actually, there's one other way we could not use the angry rabbit. If I hit F2 and the range is already highlighted by using Control-Enter, that populates that formula throughout the range. All right, so we saw how to do adding with an OR logical test, counting with an OR logical test, and a couple cool formulas for calculating the average for each team using an OR logical test. All right, if you like that video, be sure to click that thumbs up, leave a comment, and subscribe, because there's always lots more videos to come from Excel is Fun. And if you want to check out more about dynamic array formulas or conditional calculations, check out these videos.